Let's go over to his challenger's headquarters, David Ige, where Jai Cunningham standing by. Jai?
Hey, thank you very much, Joe. You talk about experience. Well, with David Ige, Senator David Ige, you're talking about close to 30 years of experience down at the state legislature, and a career that started, he was appointed to the House of Representatives by then-Governor George Ariyoshi. We're expecting the governor here at some point this evening. Another person who has put his backing to Senator Ige, that would be Representative Gregg Takayama, and also a former colleague of mine, or ours, I should say, at Channel 2.
That's right.
The reason why you put support behind Senator Ige in his run for governor?
Well, number one, he and I share the Pearl City District. He as a senator, me as a representative. So I've worked closely with him on several issues affecting our community. And he's always been a terrific teacher, terrific support. And of course, he's been a terrific leader for our community. Secondly, you know, I decided to get involved because I saw that he had a strong message of leadership for the state of Hawaii. And so that's why I decided to.
Now, we talked about it, and we heard Joe talking about it. This would be, this has never happened before, where an incumbent governor could end up not even being, making it through the primary for a second term, much less the general. What, the precedent for this? I mean, this is, this would be historical, would it not?
This would be a historic moment, you're right. And I think it speaks, number one, to the concerns that some people have about the current administration, but certainly, too, I think it's a testament to the strong grassroots support that Senator Ige has built over the past year. And it's a strong grassroots organization that really hasn't been matched, as far as I know, by any recent gubernatorial candidate.
We see lots of blue shirts in here, and I also must be very honest, I've seen a lot of red shirts, and they have four letters on them. They're called HSTA. How important do you think the Hawaii State Teachers Association has been in this campaign?
I think the HSTA support was tremendously important because they, number one, supported Senator Ige early on, and number two, they put substantial resources behind their supporting of Senator Ige. And this, of course, came at a time when Senator Ige's own campaign resources were very limited and, in fact, still are.
Joe had talked a little bit about that Honolulu Advertiser poll that was run a few weeks ago and had him up, Senator Ige had him up by 18 points. Civil Beat did a poll, had him up by 10. Yeah. Which do you think is more accurate?
Well, what we're telling our supporters is that don't believe the polls. Every vote counts. And the polls only matter if the supporters who say they support you turn out and vote. So the message to our supporters is don't believe the polls. David needs every vote. And so that's what we're hoping came through in the past several weeks for supporters of David.
You feel confident that this will be a victorious night tonight?
Well, we're optimistic, and I think the first returns will really tell a lot.
Gregg Takayama, Representative Gregg Takayama, thank you very much.
Thank you.